So today, we're going to be learning about macro photography.
We'll take you through the fundamentals of macro and even show you two cheap and easy hacks that eliminate the need for expensive specialist kit.
What is macro photography? It's just taking a photograph of a subject so that your subject is the same size or larger on the sensor as it is in real life. If we're being strict about our definitions of macro, macro photography is any photography where the reproduction ratio is 1:1 or greater. That means the image size on your sensor is the same size as it is in real life or bigger. A reproduction ratio of 2:1 would mean that the image on the sensor is twice as big as it appears in real life. In reality though, you don't need to worry about reproduction ratios. Just any close-up photography is generally given the term macro, and that's what we'll be dealing with today. It usually involves either very fine details or very small subjects like insects. Today, we're going to be looking at mundane household items and getting some pretty cool images with just things you find around your house. Macro photography is a great subject to start shooting. You can get some really striking results from the most unlikely of items. It all sounded a bit technical, but you don't need to worry about any of that. It's just the same as any other genre of photography. The same principles still apply. You've got depth of field, you've got your shutter speed, and you've got flash and lighting principles to worry about. Beyond that, there's nothing to it. So for this video, we're going to be using the Nikon D850. It's a full frame camera with a 45 megapixel sensor, but you don't need a full frame. To do macro photography, you can use full frame, you can use APS-C, whatever sensor size you want. In fact, using an APS-C size sensor will give you a little bit longer focal length from your lens choice. Our lens, we've gone for the Nikon 105mm f2.8 macro lens. That should give us a reproduction ratio of 1:1. So the lens has vibration reduction, which is fantastic for shooting macro handheld. Today we're going to be setting up on a tripod though, so I'm going to make sure that is off. That won't add any vibrations from the vibration reduction moving, trying to correct for vibrations that just aren't there. Shooting on 105mm rather than 60mm, for example, will allow us to be slightly further away from our subject. One of the setups we'll be using will be involving some glass that has to be between the camera and the subject, and this just gives us a little bit more distance to play with, especially with lighting as well. We'll be doing some off-camera lighting. Just gives us less problems with the camera shadowing the subject. We're going to be using a speed light. This is the Nikon SB5000. It's quite a powerful flash gun. We're going to be firing it wirelessly with radio triggers. We'll be using the Harnell capture triggers, the receiver and transmitter. We'll pop the receiver on the bottom of our flash. This is just going to fire our flash remotely. That way we can keep our flash away from our lens. Our lens is going to be very close to our subject, and with on-camera flash, you're likely to get some shadows cast over the subject. All that's left to do is to bring our props in. We're going to get a scene set up. Yeah, we'll get into the fundamentals of shooting macro photography. So I've got my shot set up. I'm taking a photograph of this fountain pen. It's got a nice ornate nib, and I've placed it on a copy of Treasure Island. In this corner, I've just put the lid clipped to the page. Just gives the page a nice curve so it doesn't lay flat. Set the camera up on a tripod. Here I've got a white box lid. That's going to work as a reflector, and I've got a flash over it, just over here, set wirelessly to throw light in from this side, and our reflector will fill in from the right. Now that the scene's set up, the first thing we have to do is to set our focus. I've focused on the nib of the pen. It's lovely and ornate, and it's going to be the focal point of the image. But because we're shooting so close, our depth of field is going to be very, very narrow. So I've opted for f11 here. That should give me enough depth of field to get as much of the nib in focus as I want. And then we're going to let the focus drop off and the words fall off into blur. Now we need to set our focus. As I said before, we're going to make sure the focus point is on the nib of the pen, but I'm going to use live view and manual focus to really make sure I nail the focus. So we switch this over to manual, put live view on, and then I can zoom in as far as it will go. I can tweak this until I get this focus spot on. I've set my shutter speed to 200th of a second. That's within my flash sync speed, so I won't get any dark bands appearing across the image. And because I'm shooting on a tripod, I don't need to worry about motion blur from the subject or my camera moving. I will shoot on self-timer though, so that when I press the shutter button, it doesn't move the camera and introduce any motion blur that way. I've set my flash to quarter power. Now, ready to take the shot.
Now we're going to show you a few macro hacks to get you started without having to have specialist kit. First, let's look at using axial lighting as a cheap alternative to ring flash, where we redirect the light using an angled piece of glass so it looks like the light source is coming from your camera.
So as we mentioned before, shooting macro can be notoriously tricky to light. A lot of photographers will attach a ring flash to their lens to give a nice even light over your subject. Shooting with your camera, with your flash on camera, you can end up with a shadow from your lens on your subject and it doesn't look very good. The ring flash bypasses that by being an even light all the way around your lens towards your subject. It gets rid of harsh shadows and gives you a nice even coverage. The problem being, no light comes from the center of your lens. So on shiny subjects such as coins or anything else metallic, you can end up with a dark patch in the middle where the light isn't hitting. So what we're doing here is we've set up a cheap and easy setup that will give you a similar result without having to buy a ring flash. All you need is a sheet of glass, some card, and a flash gun. So we've got our subject. We're going to be photographing this coin. To light the coin, to simulate the ring flash, we're going to be firing a flash into this glass, which will go down and up. To get the glass in place, I've got some card, and I've cut a slit out at a 45 degree angle, holds the glass up like this. Now, to get the 45 degree angle, I tried to eyeball it, didn't really get it right, so I got a piece of paper, just folded it in half, and that gives me my 45 degree angle, which I can slide in to here to get the correct angle. Then we have some hard drives here. They're just working to stop any light from the flash hitting the coin at this angle. We want all the light to be coming from the glass down to the coin and then from the coin up to the camera. At the back here is a jacket that we've placed, a black jacket, to stop the light bouncing back in. So all the light will be coming from our light source. The 105mm lens here gives us enough distance between our subject and the camera to be able to get the glass in. Shooting on a 60mm lens, you might find your camera's a bit too close and it might get a bit more tricky to get this set up. All that's left now to do is to set up the camera, set up on a tripod, pointing directly down at the coin over the glass, so you can't see the glass in the image, we're shooting through it, and I've pre-focused on the coin and locked my lens off onto manual focus. So we're shooting through a snoot here. You don't need to use a snoot, you can use a Pringles can. Anything that's long and thin, what that does is it stops light spilling out everywhere and you can accurately aim just where you want your light to go. We're going to aim at the reflection of the coin in our glass here.
Here we've lit the coin with a simple side light. It gives harsh shadows around the edge and the metal ends up with a dull sheen. On this coin we've used axial lighting, which gives the metal a much shinier appearance, and there are much less distracting shadows for an overall more appealing image.
Now, if you don't have a macro lens, you can get the same result just using a 50mm prime. They're super cheap and they work fantastic. The only drawback is you have to remove it from your camera, flip it around and hold it in position. If it's got an aperture ring, that's fantastic. It means you can set your aperture. If it doesn't, that means you're going to be locked into f2.8. We will detach the lens, flip it around, and then change our camera into manual focus. I'm going to set the focus to infinity, and then from here on in, focusing will be done by moving forward and backward to bring the subject into focus. Thanks for joining me today, guys. I really hope you enjoyed that video. Take what you've learned here today, head out around the house, find some items, throw them in, get some lights set up, and grab some macro shots.
And thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to hit the subscribe button, click the notification bell, and give the video a like whilst you're at it. Don't forget to check out some of the other photography videos we have on our channel.